What do we have here? I actually don't know a whole lot about this. This is the Bigme 1051 color, known by no other colloquial name other than that. I gotta say, the new joint boxes of Bigme is quite nice. Before, they had these multiple packages of the case, the accessory box, the USB cable, the pen, everything was separate. Now everything is just joined together. Let's look at the case first. I actually don't know what body they're using. I hope they're not using the same kind of 10.3 they've used since essentially 2019. And it looks like already this case is looking and feeling and actually smelling much different. This is smelling like real leather, and it feels like real leather. It's got a certain pull and pile to it than the just regular synthetic. Could be completely way off, but let's check it out. Oh, look at this. This clasp actually comes off entirely. So it's all magnet based now. It doesn't have any sort of rail or silicone acceptor or anything like that. And it looks like they are still going with a camera, as you can see a camera slot cut out at the top. But let's put this off to the side and see the rest of the main unit body box. The boxes are also very heavy and thickly walled. This is actually a very strong cardstock, which is important. Companies like Amazon, companies like Hanvon, for example, they're just going very minimalist with their packaging, but it could come at a detriment of your unit itself because it could get damaged in transit. I already tell while I was yapping away, this is a different unit. I've never seen that before. Let's look at the pen here. Oh, whoa, this is a, wow, look at that. Gorgeous. Actually, almost looks like they went with a white label pen because their logo should be there, but it's not. So they have a push down at the back and they have a traditional Wacom tip there. This whole thing feels like sandpaper. Feels like you could sand down a piece of wood with this thing or file your nails. This is crazy. Let's look at the accessory box right here. They finally put the accessory box in the package itself. I wonder if they call this anything because they don't really have a name for this unit. No, it's just Quick Start Guide B1051. A lot of the time, you know, they call it the X color, the pocket note, for example. This one doesn't seem to really have a name to it. So let's look at the tip situation. It'd be the same kind of thing that they've done before. You have a SD card removal tool. That's really nice. And then two additional tips at the bottom with another tip removal tool. So that's really cool. Now, as I said, this body is different. It's not completely different, but they've added a top rail to it that does not share the same form factor as their other units. I think we can slide this out at the top. We can. Wow, look at that. This is looking like an executive level of cleanliness and the overall artistic vision with this gold strip and a very subtle blue flake in this blackish blue backing. I also really like how they put the Bigme logo on the camera portion and it is not a bump, it's just flush, and they have a flash package there. That's a nice touch. I feel that brings a little bit more character to it because traditionally these units do look pretty simple. You have a Bigme logo at the back right there and there's no Bigme logo at the front. Now this does use the same kind of layout body as the previous units with its kind of dual ledger design, and a lot of people ask what that's for. Well, if it was on the other hand, you would see you'd be interacting with the screen. Why they have it asymmetrical is so you don't touch the screen. And now they have this rail up top, which before they had their microphones at the top there. What they've done is they've added this rail, put the four microphones right there, two right there, and two right there. And they've added the speaker at the top with a fingerprint power button as well as a USB-C. And look at this, they've redesigned the SD card door. That's really nice. Let's go ahead and open this up and see what's inside here. I love that, how they just put this nice little kind of cross hatching on it just to add a little bit of flavor. Really nice redesign, I would say. And of course, you have some pogo pins at the back, five copper pins for various accessories that you'd put on there. We're just going to do a first time boot up to see what it's all about on the inside, but we're going to wait till we do the full review, of course. And we can snap this to the side. Ooh, that snaps really tight. That's nice. We have some devices like the V-Woods, for example, that doesn't really hold the pen that well. This one's pretty nice. doesn't jiggle or anything like that. It doesn't fall off. You know, it's almost a, this is almost a, I don't even know how you call it. It's like a portrait landscape bias device at the same time with these two angles converging into a 90 degree point. It's very interesting. Quick Cliff's Note version of the overall operating system. It doesn't look that much different, honestly. You have your app center, you have your top drop down. It's very business as usual, which is a good thing. That means when you buy this, you're not faced with a learning curve of some devices like Hanvon, for example, or iReader, that it just, you have to learn from the ground up. This is very familiar. In fact, it's very Onyx-like as well. So even if you go from a parallel move to something else, it's not going to be a shock to your sensibilities. But we're going to get into the whole thing during a full review. Thank you so much to BigMe for sending us this sample of the B1051, known as, well, the B1051, because it doesn't really have a name. Stay tuned for the full review.